always get the horse's head down. I'm always pushing the horse's hind end underneath themselves so that the horse will retract its neck on its own and get more on the bit. So let's shorten your reins and start as a group. That'll be fun today. You get to play with each other today. So we're going to shorten the reins and we're going to trot as a group. Big trot. And as you're trotting, I want you to think about the rhythm of the horse. And I want you to think about just little steps of leg heel away from your inside leg as you turn. And that isn't to teach the horse how to lose their hindquarters, it's simply to teach the horse how to use the hindquarters. There's a difference. So take the outside rein on the black horse and kick the little horse forward. And don't worry about the drama he wants to give you. That's just the drama. In a minute, yes.
Okay.
Not right this second. So, Ricky, when you feel him get stuffy about holding the outside rein and he wants to go behind the bit like that, make sure that you tell him with your leg first and then with your whip, go forward. But don't give away the rein, because that's what he wants to do, to go forward. That's a girl. And then sometimes horses will come out and the left side is cranky and the right side isn't, so let's change direction. Your position's better today, Ricky. And so is Tracy. Nothing like mirrors, huh? There you go. All right. Now we can go side by side, Tracy. Yeah, right up there. Big trot. Yay! So when a horse prior to repair as long as they respond to the forward. If you were in a warm-up arena and you didn't do left-to-left, you would have had a big crash. Better. And some horses warm up like a little bit more, labored than others. But why don't you go ahead and count? Your hands down, keep your legs coming. Good. Keep coming. All the way around the arena. Go. Good girl. Good. Keep coming. Yeah. Follow in the hands and keep it coming. Give a little smack with the whip and don't overbend it. And make sure that when you use that whip, that you don't say yes, no by grabbing him in the mouth right after he's responded to the whip. That's way better. And trot, outside leg steady. Super. And go. Good ride. And go the other way. As an amateur, most people, when they first get on their horses, they are not as supple as they will be at the end of the ride. So make sure you don't use that in a disadvantaged way, that you keep moving around until you're pretty supple, and then you can ask for more difficult things. And Tantra? Good girl. So you're going to ask him to get a little bit more forward. You're going to touch him to the whip, but not get in his face. Catch that one. Come on, Tim. Yay! So now you could, everyone can see that this horse is straighter in the head. Doesn't have to tilt. And that's because he's getting to the point where he wants to go on both reins. Every horse comes out and there will be more feel on one side than the other, just because of their suppleness. That has nothing to do with suppleness. That was a foot that was out there to look at. Very good. And back to the trot. So that would be a very good warm-up for me for to go in the ring. Try not to, when he goes above the bit, try thinking more forward than pulling back. Because what he does is he goes, I don't hear you, so he doesn't hear you. and then there you are, hand out of forward. Let them walk now. Good job. So for me, with a horse like this, I wouldn't even worry about on the bit, I would worry about let's go, let's go, let's go. And then, you know, 10 minutes into the ride, you've loosened up, he's loosened up, and everybody's having harmony. When you first begin, if you're messing with his head, he just goes lost on your bridle, and then the leg means nothing. And for him, brakes are way more exciting than his nose, I think.
And I'm working on my stopping him with my hands too much in the back of it.
Yeah. Think that the legs mean something, and if they mean something, then you don't have to work so hard. That's being successfully selfish. Because if you're successfully selfish, you make somebody else do it. All right, let's have the next horse.